That might get behind us.
Well, being behind is going to be no good. He has to be. I have to be behind.
Where is he?
He's right there.
He's waiting for you.
And being behind him, you know, good.
We got a headlight out. We're getting pulled over. The camera's ready.
I should be fine on the way up. It's coming back is going to be the problem.
Mommy never get the meatballs in there again. They sucked. Cake was a little bit stale, too. Big City wasn't bad, though. Salad was good. Soup was good.
Boy, I wish I had this rusty wrench a year or two ago.
Why? Oh, that bust out of here as well.
You're my favorite girl up there. Well, I've never seen that. And I go, oh, boy, I guess since you never seen it, it must not exist. Oh, I went the hell off on her, man. Fuck. Since you never heard of it, oh my god. And then the third time I knew I was, because they don't, you know, it's got a receipt under a year, and then you bring back your, you know, thing, whatever, except for the little 10-pound clicker, you know. We don't exchange calibration tools. I said, your goddamn medics warranty this.
I broke my fucking leather, man. Wave. Snapped one of the pliers jaws off.
Send it in.
I didn't realize they had a warranty. I thought it was only a couple years. No, I thought it was 5 years, actually. So I went on eBay, found another one, bought it. $42 used, but in good condition. With a couple extra knives with it. But that's not wave number three that I've had in the last 10, 12 years or so.
She had a couple of Leathermans up there.
And then I looked on the website just to see what they cost new. And I see warranty. What's that? 25 years. I haven't even made the wave for 25 years, so I know they're all fucking warranted. Unconditional. And, oh, shit.
Yeah, that's how you send it in. Like,
I did send it in. Right on the spot. Put it in a little box, label it, sent it out this morning. Now I got to find my original wave, which is really fucked up. And send it in, if I can find it, somewhere.
I got a couple from the military that I was issued.
Leatherman waves?
No, Leatherman multi.
Oh, regular multi-tools, yeah. I have a broken regular multi-tool, too, someplace. But that's well over 25 years old. Yeah, that's $100.
They're not cheap.
No, and it was more expensive when I first bought it.
I got them in the 90s, like these multi-tool thingies. They're
well, actually, the one I just turned in, I bought used. That was an eBay buy. But the original one I bought new. Way back in 2000, I think it was. Or whenever it first came out. It was a brand new issue at that time. And, you know, everything eventually broke on it. The jaws got fucked up, the blade snapped, saw snapped, a few other things came apart. You know, when it got to the point I couldn't use it anymore, I just bought a used one. Stuck it back in the pouch. You know, that's what I've been using.
She's awful, that one. Yeah, I had no problem.
Well, no longer employed there, apparently. So.
I don't know if she had fired or if they moved her. But like, I have to, after the third time, then I went in the fourth time, and then, you know, she's like, they said she's not here or no longer here. I mean, you should be in a different department or...
Maybe she saw you coming and she scurried into the back.
She had a big mouth, that one. I had a bigger mouth. I was loud and obnoxious, too. You'd never seen me like that. And I was like, you goddamn gonna warranty this. I said, get the freaking manager. Comes out, and he's like, yeah. I said, yeah. I said, what's that say? He's like, oh. I said, yeah, oh. Here we go again with her. Yeah, I was bitching about her.
Don't know the color of
problem is I'm spoiled by Ronnie's Italian food. You can leave it up, Scott. It's all right.
No. I feel like I'm going back down to Jersey on a Sunday night. That's what this really reminds me of. If you pick it up, it's 90.7 WFUV out of Fordham University.
Sure, you can get them all on the computer. Then again, you gotta remember, I have a lot of these original songs on 78s.
It's called The Big Broadcast. Big Broadcast on 90.7. I would have saw that right away. You'll see it right off. want to stop at Cousins for anything?
No, I'm all right. Liquor store.
What else is there?
Saturday night, they're all getting liquored up.
You got three places. You got the Chinese, the bakery, the pizza, and this.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty much in the gas station.
Well, they'll be busy exercising their arms later. No satanic rituals there tonight, I guess.
Oh.
tonight.
Yeah. Comes the seatbelt, in goes a little fake clip. We are now in violation again of New York State traffic and safety law.
It's not a fake clip, that's a real seatbelt clip.
You're not wearing your seatbelt, is what it is. They don't care about the clip, in fact, you're not wearing seatbelts. On a public highway here. And you got a headlight out, which means we've doubled our chances of getting stopped. There's a trooper right now. There's another trooper. Oh.
What are you? Wait for? Oh, no.
Pennsylvania does that there on the other side of the road like that.
That's why you were slowing down.
Pennsylvania does that shit. No, they don't do it in New York, but that's a Pennsylvania thing. And they'll be right on the other side of the road with the headlights on.
Oh, another trooper. What the heck are you doing? Doing a stealth approach? Mike's not even home. Maybe Mike stopped the cousins. He probably did. Might as well pull in.
I was thinking about it.
Yeah, he probably did. He didn't have dessert over there, remember?
Thank you.
Somebody coming.
Stealthy.
You can have more than your share. It don't affect your weight. When you hear that bill of fare, a sweetness on for dinner never hurt. And the pepper for dessert, you should try the mother side of love.
Turkey, Mikey.
You got them.
Yeah, Phillips. These are the.
Oh, so we didn't ever put the good ones in.
I don't remember. Or I said wait until these go and then.
So you know what we'll do is we'll change them both.
Keep one as a spare.
Keep one as a spare. This is actually one too. I don't know. I must have put it in here because it's still good.
What's your card take?
It looks still good. I don't know. Might even be for mine. I don't know. Because I know one blew on mine too, but I don't know if it's a 9006. All right. Yeah. So these are the ones.
Oh boy. I'm burping meatball.
You're gonna have to go looking for Spikey because he's not here.
Where is he?
My parents' house.
What's he doing down there?
He's going to the vet. Emergency visit.
Why? What happened?
His.
Uh-huh. I guess
the battery's
so.
Not being held down by anything, sir.
What happened to Spikey?
Should have taken a picture of his old upper lip. It was all swollen out, puffy. So it happened before on his lower lip. And they think it's an allergic reaction.
Huh.
He said, no plastic. You can't, don't have them around plastic, so.
How are you going to fucking avoid that?
Shit, the whole house is plastic.
Yeah.
Well, like, no plastic food dishes. The food I've been giving them, this stuff here, well, he's eating some of it anyway, comes in a plastic container. And the water dish.
Plastic
water thing.
Water found plastic.
So he's at my parents' house. He got an algae shot, which really took care of him the last time. And so, we'll see.
Well, Mr. Winky's looking for a home.
Well, a lot of times I have to take him down there for a weekend. We just keep him.
He said, that guy that was asking about me today, am I going to live with him? Yep.
My house is full.
That's why the battery's loose, probably from fucking out of light bulbs with that much. I guess so. That's his cigar and car money. He doesn't spend that for this. Burnt out.
So I remember the blog said it needs Phillips or the OEM.
And they never lie on blogs.
Oh, no, I know. Well, I'm saying this is after I put the Sylvania in.
This is the wrong one.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
This is the
high. Guess I'm going to be getting my ticket. Oh, that's okay. My camera wants to see you get one.
Sort of sound like Terry.
I don't want a ticket. I have to say it.
What was on the wine list today?
Everything.
Shit. The other day, Thursday morning, man, I thought, I almost ran out of ass with a shotgun in my fucking hand.
Why?
4 to 6 in the morning. Girl lives next door. House is opening up over there.
Yeah.
Quarter to six in the morning. Outside in the backyard. My throat's killing me, but it's screaming. It's on top of her fucking.
What the fuck about?
No! I jump out of fucking bed like, holy fuck, someone's being fucking murdered next door. It's screaming, echoing. I'm like, what in the fuck? Fuck is going on? Apparently one of the little hot dog puppies is running towards the woods.
Yep.
And she was very upset about it.
You gotta be shitting me.
Screaming.
Holy crap.
You, screaming. It scared the shit out of me. I opened the window and I see the husband come flying out of the fucking house, down the fucking stairs. I gotta swam running into the woods with my holy shit.
I'd have been so fucking pissed. One, you woke my fucking ass up. Two, I had to jump out of bed, run out of the fucking house in my pajamas with a fucking gun.
Yeah.
It's
your only day off.
They got them lucky because that would have been a very dramatic fucking moment if I was, you know, somebody screaming outside my fucking place like that.
Thank God.
Yeah, that one definitely no good.
Oh, the filament's all shaking around in there?
Did you give him a fucking what for about that shit?
No, I didn't even met them yet.
Oh, I didn't met him right then and there. I said, look, you want to be good neighbors? Don't ever fucking do that again. Ever. Unless you're fucking actually dying. I see you lying there in a pool of your own entrails. Consider my sleep more valuable than diamonds.
No, 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 no. And the echo, I'm sure, made it worse, you know, but it was, I'm telling you, screaming. I was like, holy fuck. I really thought someone was getting fucking murdered.
Go out there, expect to see
these
giant bloody steak knife.
Yeah, don't make me, somebody's got it. Somebody's attacking her, or...
A bear had wandered out of the woods.
Yeah,
and,
you know. Something was going on.
Jesus Christ. They package them securely, don't they?
It's hard to get out of the car, out of the package.
You see any cops on the way up?
Nope, were there any?
I saw a couple cars without headlight, with one headlight.
I didn't see any cops,
though. No, I didn't see any. I was looking for him, but I didn't see him.
We were watching.
Of course, Scott took his seatbelt off at the bridge. I'd have left my ass off if we did get pulled over for that fucking headlight, and there is no seatbelt. Well, I'm going to let you skate on the headlight thing, but, sir, you were not wearing a seatbelt. I'm going to have to ticket you for that.
Your military ID is not going to get you out of there.
Starting to leak, that's all. Hmm? Just, the seals are starting to leak, gotta get new headlights.
Well, what's the...
Yeah, it's, you know, car's over 10 years old, plastic only lasts so long. At least it's not haze, look at it that way.
Yeah.
That's usually what happens.
What are the rubber seals in here go down?
Nah, it's just it's a plastic epoxy. They start to pinhole it and vibration here and there. Shit starts leaking.
Well, I know that
time.
Ain't gonna make the it should make the bulbs go bad, right?
No, not particularly.
No, this is a good one, right?
No.
And maybe don't touch it.
Well, I'll say
you can put it in this thing.
Yeah, put it right back in there. Where do you go?
Yeah. Just put that in a little baggie and then. Some Mopars did that in the 70s. Taillights would get old.
Yeah.
Well, you know, fish tank.
They weren't exactly well sealed,
you know. The satellite never really did it till towards the end.
Fucking GMs did it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
2 months old.
Fish tank.
Oh, God.
Damn. Yeah.
Good to go.
No ticket tonight, I guess. But at least not
well, not lights. For that, no.
And then I got one other thing.
Oh.
My airbag light.
What about it?
Is now permanently on, but I think it's because I fuck with something in here. Because I took the seats out to clean it and unplugged the... So is that...
Well, you'll never pass inspection again, but other than that. And the airbag actually could deploy.
No. Oh, don't deploy, huh?
Only over 60 miles an hour.
Or is it because I got to reset the maintenance light?
Well, the maintenance light is on too?
Well, that I think you just reset that. They're holding the ignition on and then holding the trip on there.
John, you're gonna get Jim pulled from YouTube.
No, that's okay. This is all public domain music. My CD.
I don't know if I'm gonna pull an airbag code, but.
Well, didn't these cars have a recall in the airbags?
I just did it.
Maybe they fucked something up.
No, I think it's something I did.
Take apart what you did. What'd you do?
When you take the seats out, you unbolt the seats.
I ain't taking the fucking seat out.
No, I know that. What I'm saying, that's the.
Is there always there anything under there?
You don't need black tape, Scott. Take black tape, put over sensor, ignore. You can't see the light; it's not on.
This is your problem. What's this?
Those are the tools I gave him to turn in.
Those are the tools off the Titanic.
What's this? Where's my light?
That one? Can't tell.
I remember that light.
Here's the keys. Keys in?
Keys.
Make sure you don't sit on the screwdriver.
I know. I don't want that up my ass, Scott. I'm watching. Not the leather I'm worried about. My ass.
Come on, Jim. You don't go that way?
No.
Right. Get my glasses up there, Scott.
Glasses.
I'm surprised you never put a good radio in here. It's usually the first thing you do.
I just thought of that. He has done that in every other car you've had. Light went off, didn't it?
No, it's open.
Oh, I didn't see that one.
Pass, no codes found.
Seatbelt light error due to owner fuck up.
Was there anything under here when you took it apart?
No, just the two. It's under the seat. I you know what? Give me a socket and a ratchet wrench. I'll pull the seat out. I know. Because maybe I didn't snap it back together enough.
And there's one connection here. It's plugged in.
There's two of them. There should be two. Two on each side. Like I said, I'll pull the seat back out.
So there's four altogether?
Two on each side.
Oh, two on driver's side, two on the passenger side, I see.
Like a little blue one and like a...
This is a yellow connector, which is airbag.
And here we have his little secret seatbelt device. So here it is, folks. This is how he flouts the law. Keep the seatbelt buzzer from beeping while he's driving around town without his seatbelt on.
Oh, there's the other connector.
I didn't hear that annoying beeping.
Yeah, well, if you wear a seatbelt, you don't hear it at all.
Has it been a screwdriver?
I don't think I did. I probably found it that way. It's just in a bucket of tools, you know, I used to keep in one of the old vans there full of crap. Find some in the car, toss it in.
Jesus Christ.
What happened?
Trying to unplug it. I don't know what the fuck he did. If you want, I'll take the seat out, and then all you do is just rock it up. It makes it easier to get to the plug.
He's got his hands on the plug, so it seems like he got it in.
Did I snap it in all the way, or...?
Was this that thing you were talking about? USB plug like this? That you lost for plugging things into the... No? Okay. This is a double one. I never saw a double one before.
Give me a small screwdriver, Scott.
Flathead?
Huh?
Flathead?
Flathead or Phillips?
Yeah, flathead.
I got the bent one here if you want.
Yeah, let me try it. How'd you get this connector apart, Scott?
I took the seat, I unbolted the seat, and then you...
That's got nothing to do with getting the connector apart. How'd you get the connector apart?
You two fingers on each side. That's why I said it's easier to pull. I'll pull the seat out. Two seconds, I'll pull the seat right out.
I got the connector in my hand, Scott.
Oh, okay.
Two fingers, I ain't pulling shit.
Because what I'm thinking, I didn't snap it and click it.
No, it snapped, it's clicked. I wanted to look at the connection, but I can't get the fucking thing apart.